At the close of last week, the new White House deputy press secretary, TJ Ducklo, was facing calls for resignation over threatening misogynistic messages that were sent to a female reporter. At that point, TJ Ducklo had been suspended without pay for 1 week, which hardly seemed to match up to the things that were said. Well, now, a few days later, message from the press secretary that we have accepted the resignation of TJ Ducklo after a conversation with him this evening. This conversation occurred with the support of the White House chief of staff. We are committed to striving every day to meet the standards set by the president and treating others with dignity and respect, with civility and with a value for others through our words and actions. TJ Ducklo also put out, that's a real name, also put out a statement saying, "No words can express my regret, my embarrassment, and my disgust for my behavior. I use language that no woman should ever have to hear from anyone, especially in a situation where she was just trying to do her job. It was language that was abhorrent, disrespectful, and unacceptable. I am devastated to have embarrassed and disappointed my White House colleagues and President Biden. And after discussion with White House communications leadership tonight, I resign my position and will not be returning from administrative leave." He further said that he is determined to earn back the trust of everyone he let down because of his intolerable actions. Francesca, what are your thoughts on this update?
Well, I'm sure the Daily Wire will provide him with a movie that he can star in and act in, because he's been wronged by the cancel culture. And I am happy to provide it. I mean, look at this. This is exactly what happens. You know, you have to apologize for every little move. You know, oh, she's you know, this is what women have to always be taken care of. I'm trying to do Shapiro. I don't know if I'm.
I thought it was pretty good.
Yeah, thanks. I don't have my underwear all the way up the crack, so it's not bunched. And so I think that's how you
hashtag
get the sound.
Show us the
hashtag show.
Come on, Ben.
Yeah, show us the Ben undies.
I don't want to finish it.
Look, it's nice that like we're back to a White House that actually like has some humility. Humility, just basic humility. You know, it's saying that you're gonna destroy someone. Coming from inside the White House, like that's not good. Don't say that to somebody.
Yeah,
and it was over a romantic relationship, am I right?
Yes, it was over questions that were being asked about a relationship that TJ Ducklo was having with an Axios reporter. And TJ Ducklo was saying that the female reporter who had been assigned this story was only asking because she was jealous of the Axios reporter and that some man had had sex with the Axios reporter that didn't have sex with her. None of this is acceptable. So look, two things I think are true simultaneously. One, good. This is, I think, what people wanted and they did it. And I can't imagine under the previous administration that this would have happened. I mean, Trump stuck more with the wife beating press guy he had than they did with Ducklo, which is good. That said, yeah, his apology strikes me as, we'll see where he tries to pop up again. And I'm sure he's just trying to like protect himself. And that's fine. And by the way, even the thing from the press secretary is like, we strive to meet the standards set by the president, which is why we knew about this story for a couple of weeks and did nothing until it came out. And even then tried to just suspend him. And when that wasn't enough, only then did we ask for him to resign. That's how we strive to meet the Biden challenge. It's fake. And that's not what you were doing. You were doing what people do, which is you tried to get away with not doing anything until you had to. But that said, they did get him to resign. So huzzah.
Yeah. I thought the whole communications team was all female too.
I had heard that too. I mean, I guess I heard that too. I don't know. Maybe he was a late hire or they were talking about some other subset of it. I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, this is
closer to all female now.
Yeah, I'm glad. Look, I think that's important. I think that's good. Like, hey, standards are important. At the same time, once again, we just got done talking about a party that literally won't condemn a violent insurrection against themselves, against the Republic. So I don't know, like we're not playing the same game. That's the other thing. Now, I don't think the answer is to be like, nah, take no prisoners, no humility, whatever, just blaze forward. Like that's definitely not the course. But once again, we're in these two different realities. And I'm glad that at least there's some decency left in one of them.
Yeah, exactly.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.